I've been to USA several times. Once when I went to USA after 9/11, in the year 2003, I had gone to Los Angeles. I was invited to be given an award by a Muslim society, Muslim organization. And when I landed in the Los Angeles airport in USA, I'm prepared the way I'm dressed up. Coat, tie, suit, but kufia, cap, beard. Very good target. I wear this cap, beard, because it's a commandment of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Trousers above the ankle, commandment of Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Wearing the cap, it's a sunnah. At the same time wearing a suit and a tie, looking modern, no problem, it's not haram. But a soft target. And I'm prepared, the eye should be prepared. When I enter, when I land in the Los Angeles airport, the immigration, oh, cap and a beard, go for inquiry. There they asked me a question, what is the profession? I said, my profession is to spread truth. I'm a dai. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, seek ye the truth and truth shall free you. Mentioned in the Gospel of John. So I'm a dai. Who are you? I said, what type of a Muslim are you? I said, I'm a Muslim. No, what type, what sect of Muslim are you? Are you a Wahhabi? I said, yes, I'm Wahhabi. I'm Abdul Wahhab. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is called as Wahhab, the bestower. I'm Abdul Wahhab. I'm a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In that context, I'm a Wahhabi. But by label, I'm a Muslim. So what type of Muslim? Shia Muslim, Sunni Muslim? I said, in Islam, there is no sect. I said, if you read the Quran, Quran says there's no sect in Islam. I'm a Muslim. So to cut the story short, when I went to the customs, I know that I'm going to be checked. It's coming. I'm used to it, traveling to Western countries several times. When they opened my suitcase, they saw one of my DVDs, Terrorism and Jihad, with a pistol on it. On the cover of the DVD, the topic was Terrorism and Jihad, an Islamic perspective. So the customs office asked me that, do you believe in jihad? I said, yes. I believe in jihad. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, believed in jihad. He said to strive and struggle. Even I strive and struggle. No, sir. Do you believe in to fight? I said, Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said you should fight. If you read the Bible, the Old Testament, in the book of Exodus, chapter number 22, verse number 18 to 20, it says you have to fight. In the book of Exodus, chapter number 32, verse number 27, 28. In the book of Numbers, chapter number 31, verse number 1 to 18. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter number 19, verse number 27. Gospel of Luke, chapter number 22, verse number 36. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, take the sword and fight. So Jesus Christ said, you have to fight. No, that wasn't self-defense. I said, even I believe in fighting in self-defense. Sir, can we ask you one more question? All the custom officers gathered and there was a big... All the custom officers left their customers and they came to me. Sir, can we ask you one more question? In 2003, after 9/11, I just made a phone call to my host that don't worry, you know, I'm doing dawah here. My host would be worried, why hasn't Zakir come out for more than an hour? See, I quote, the moment I started quoting the Bible, they said, sir, can we ask you one more question? And they were happy. At least I removed the misconception from the custom officers and the immigration officers of USA. No problem. I was there in UK.